Hello and welcome to BBC News. French prosecutors have begun a terrorism investigation after a man armed with a knife lashed out at passers-by in central Paris. One person was killed and at least four others were injured. The attacker was shot dead by police. It took place in Opéra, which is one of the busiest districts of the city. It's around 9:30 in the evening. Eyewitnesses said the knife man shouted Allahu Akbar, and later the so-called Islamic State said it was behind the attack. The French President Emmanuel Macron said on Twitter that France had once again paid the price of blood. Bill Hayton reports.
It should have been a pleasant night out in a popular part of Paris. Instead, a victim lies stabbed in the street. Eyewitnesses reported scenes of panic as an attacker lashed out with a blade. Investigators say he shouted Allahu Akbar, Arabic for God is great. Police flooded the area near the Opera House, and eyewitnesses said officers first tried to taser the suspect and then fired two shots. The authorities have confirmed the attacker is dead.
The police arrived quickly. Everyone arrived quickly. We didn't know what was going on. We were quickly moved inside the bar. I went outside and I saw a man lying on the floor.
President Macron said his thoughts were with the victims and their loved ones. He saluted the courage of the police officers who, in his words, neutralised the terrorist. The city's mayor said that all Parisians stood by the victim's side. The incident is being treated as terrorism, but there's been no word on the background of the attacker. The Islamic State group has claimed responsibility, saying it was targeting countries of the coalition that fought against it in the Middle East.
La France est déterminée.
France is absolutely determined not to yield in any way to the threats issued by attackers. Our response will be firm and clear.
Faire peser sur elle.
Over the past 3 years, a string of jihadist attacks around France have claimed the lives of almost 250 people. As the investigation continues, police will remain on high alert. Bill Hayton, BBC News.